Mandag 4. mai var pressefrihetens dag. På Litteraturhuset i Oslo ble det blant annet arrangert debatt om hvordan den arabiske våren har påvirket demokratiet og pressefriheten.
There's an enormous enthusiasm, you know, for democracy and what it means and for the media. And the real problem is that because of the violence, and you've seen it, it's very difficult to imagine that out of this violence something importantly valuable for democracy will emerge. But I firmly believe that.
Aidan White er direktør i Ethical Journalism Network og jobber for journalisters rettigheter. I Tunisias tilfelle tror han særlig den nye grunnloven har vært viktig for landets utvikling.
You look at the constitution from Tunisia. It has absolutely confirmed free expression as a fundamental right. Also, equality between men and women as a fundamental right. The whole sort of question of what democracy means in practice to a whole society has actually been well crafted and enshrined and represented in the constitution. And what's important to say is that for Tunisians, the constitution is not a piece of idle gossip or unimportant statements or declarations. It actually, they see it as fundamental. People live by the law and the ability of the law to protect their rights and interests. Could the revolution have taken place without that constitution? Could press freedom have been put in place without that constitution? My answer would be absolutely not.